Thank you. It resists, but defends itself from what can set it free. The path to understanding leads through contradiction. We deny one simple fact, the fact that humans are the real monsters. And as such, we should treat each other. Although I had been deluding myself otherwise for so many years, I have finally figured out my true nature. Remember that in the darkness, you are never alone. There is always someone who awaits your fall.
Thank you. Thank you. Finally, we made it to the pass. Thank God, we made it. On our way, I felt someone was following us. I heard strange whispers around. I sometimes even caught a glimpse of a moving shadow in the trees. There were moments I could feel someone's breath upon my shoulder, but when I stopped still, hearing the snow crunching under one's boots, and turned around, there was nobody there. I had the impression this is a place of some horrid altar of madness. Nothing is as it should be. Or it's some kind of a nightmare. And then we found the bodies. Something told me not to look, but it looked like something was sticking out. Or maybe there was just some voice in my head which kept repeating, "Go down there, go." I can hear it clearly even now. So I went down and found the remaining four. The way they looked, what on earth could have happened to them? I'm not able to describe it in detail. Smashed skulls, twisted limbs, broken ribs, torn, cut or burnt skin. Never ever have I seen anything like this. A gruesome image of madness or some sick experiment. As if someone or something played with them and abandoned the destroyed toys in the forest. I felt madness was slowly but firmly overcoming my soul.
Time does not heal wounds, as I've recently learned. This truth was pounded into me by pain, cruelty, and lies. I learned from this. I remembered. It nearly touched the essence of my understanding, becoming the revelation of truth, when they dragged me down the corridor with my shattered bones. When they operated on me to observe the misplacement of my organs. When they put the worst nightmares into my head. When they closed me up, put me together again, and revived me over and over to test the limits of my endurance. And when finally, after so many years, they told me my wife was dead. Time does not heal wounds.
The window vent. We ate breakfast, packed our things, and at 11 a.m. we were ready to go. We set off in the back of a truck, so it was a bit cold. During the ride, we talked about absolutely everything we could think of. On the spot, we spoke with some local workers. I remembered one in particular. He had a red beard. Friends called him Beardman. We cooked and ate dinner, and now we are resting. Half of the group is looking at some maps, the rest are sleeping. I started handling the equipment and writing. It is still a bit too cold. My hands are shaking, but finally, my thoughts are much brighter than yesterday. No creepiness in them whatsoever. There's a long way ahead of us, but the only thing I can feel is excitement. It seems as if the forest is calling us. That beautiful, magical, dark forest.
Thank you.
Minotaur back.
Starting to set. I see it like I am there myself, as if I'm standing there in the middle of the forest. I'm not sure what is going on with reality. I'm writing with my own blood on a tree. My own name, Anton. No, not mine. His. The sun is just starting to set. Orange mist all around. I see their bodies coming out of the woods. I hear a scream, a horrific scream of terror. Is that my voice? I think it is. Where's Anton? Where did he come from? How did he get in? The sun is just starting to set. He's in me. He's in my head. He's coming in through my eyes. The eyes are windows to the soul. Where is Anton? I am dropping in a bottomless abyss, falling into the pass. Dead and rotting hands are catching me on my way down. I can feel them whisper into my ear. Now you are ours. You will never leave us. I'm calling him. I'm calling Anton. Where is Anton? I don't know. I see nothing. My eyes are overflowing with blood. I have to escape. I have to run away. I have to start running. The sun is just starting to set.
Thank you.
My body is a shell, and I am ready to absorb him.
They clearly got worse just as our mood. We set off quite late today. I think everyone heard something at night, but they are afraid to admit it. I walked around the tents, but didn't notice any tracks. We didn't talk too much. We barely hiked.
Thank you.
It's dark. We escaped to the forest. Someone, something tried to get in the town.
My dear Vera.
I wanted to make things right. I believed God itself touched me. That I have received a chance, a compensation for the evil that was brought upon me. Then I understood that it is not God, or good, or restitution. Just a tool of revenge.
Thank you. Whoever you are, if you are reading these words, I beg of you, help us. We are in a place they call Post Office Box 5. I don't know it.
And so, we have reached the end. Have you understood your role in my plan? There are no random victims, and nobody is completely innocent. You may not agree, but when the gates to Section 22 open and the world through mad, you will understand that everything I had done was necessary.
Is that you? safe on your last stop. You said a bright warm light won't bring you home. Did you lie, my dear? Did you lie? The day is dark, I'm all alone. If you are there, just let me know. Ashes arise, the light shall fall. Will you find me? Will you find me? When the sky is dead and forever gone, will you find me? Will you find me? Ashes arise, light shall fall. Will you find me? Will you find me? When the sky